లైన్ y ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎక్స్ ఈస్ టాంజెంట్ టు y ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఈ పవర్ ఎక్స్, టాంజెంట్ టు y ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు లాగ్ ఎక్స్, టాంజెంట్ టు బోత్ y ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఈ పవర్ ఎక్స్ అండ్ y ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు లాగ్ ఎక్స్, నీదర్ టచెస్ ఈ పవర్ ఎక్స్ నార్ y ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు లాగ్ ఎక్స్. Dear students, this problem can easily solve if you know the graphical approach. Look at this, dear students. I'm just trying to draw the graph of e power x, x and log x. Do you agree with me? This is y is equal to x. Is that correct? This is y is equal to x. And y is equal to e power x is clearly like this. It will not touch y is equal to x at all. E power x is equal to x do not have a solution at all. Therefore, e power x never meets x. And what about log x? Log x is nothing but replica of this over this particular line. Therefore, y is equal to log x also will not meet this curve. Therefore, y is equal to x neither touches y is equal to log x nor touches y is equal to e power x. Therefore, option C is correct. Option D is correct. Very importantly, dear students, here you must know this. This point is 0, 1 and this point is 1, 0. Right? And however, these two points are equidistant from y is equal to x. And so, the curves y is equal to log x and y is equal to e power x are equidistant from y is equal to x, and y is equal to x will not cut or touch the curve y is equal to log x and y is equal to e power x. Y is equal to x will not touch or cut the curves y is equal to e power x and y is equal to log x. Got it? Look at the next question. The question is like this. You have given y is equal to f of x and you are asked to find out maximum slope or when the slope is maximum. Students, you should know this. To find out maxima and minima, we have a rule. What is that rule? Find out f of x, f dash of x, f double dash of x. If f double dash of x is positive, then there exists a minima when x is equal to 0. F double dash of x is negative, then there exists a maxima when x is equal to 0. This is a familiar concept to you. But here, you are asked to find out maximum slope. Then what you have to do is, you have to find out f dash of x. After finding out f dash of x, then you make it as g of x, then find out maxima and minima of g of x. Look at the question, dear students. Let f of x is equal to e power x cos x, slope of the curve y is equal to f of x is maximum at x is equal to option A 0, option B pi by 2, option C 3 pi by 2 and option D is pi. Look at this, dear students. Let us consider g of x itself is f dash of x. Right away I am writing it. G of x is differentiation of e power x cos x. That is e power x into, first we are keeping cos x constant. Differentiation of e power x is e power x. Now I am keeping e power x constant. Differentiation of cos x is minus sin x. That means to say, I have to put a bracket here. Actually, minus sin x into e power x I should write. So, I am writing e power x into cos x minus sin x. This is a new function. You are asked to find out, actually g of x is what? G of x is nothing but equal to f dash of x. Now, g of x itself is a new function for us. You are asked to find out slope of the curve, that is, this is slope of the curve, is maximum when g of x is a maximum is the simplest definition of this problem, where g of x is f dash of x. So now what is g dash of x, dear students? G dash of x is given by, if you observe carefully, e power x is differentiated, keeping this as constant, I will write cos x minus sin x. Next, I should write plus, keep e power x constant, differentiate cos x minus sin x. What is differentiation of cos x? Differentiation of cos x is minus sin x. And what is differentiation of sin x? That is cos x. Therefore, minus cos x. Can we simplify that further? Yes, we can. So, what is the simplification? That is equal to e power x, we can take common. We have cos x, right? And we have minus cos x. Do you agree with me? Cos x minus cos x cancels. We have minus sin x, that is minus 2 sin x. Is that correct? Now, what is g dash of x? G dash of x is e power x into minus 2 sin x, that is the first part. And differentiation of sin x is cos x, that means to say g dash of x will be, g double dash of x will be e power x into minus 2 sin x. Is that correct? E power x into minus 2 sin x. And by keeping minus 2 sin x, we differentiated e power x plus, right, e power x you keep as it is, differentiate minus 2 sin x, we'll get minus 2 cos x. Is that correct? Now that is g double dash of x. If g dash of x is equated to 0, what happens? G dash of x is equated to 0, you will get e power x into minus 2 sin x is equal to 0. So let g dash of x is equal to 0. Let g dash of x is equal to 0, this clearly implies x is equal to 0. Is that correct? Because g dash of x is 0 means minus 2 sin x is equal to 0. That means to say x is equal to 0. If I substitute x is equal to 0 in g double dash of x, we'll get g double dash of 0 is equal to e power minus 2 sin 0, that is 0, e power 0 into minus 2 cos 0, that is negative. We will get e power 0 into minus 2. That is g double dash of x is negative. So, g double dash of x is negative. As g double dash of x is negative, then there exists a maxima when g dash of x is equated to 0. When g dash of x is equated to 0, we got x is equal to 0. As we got x is equal to 0, that clearly says option A is correct. So, slope of the curve y is equal to f of x is maximum when x is equal to 0. Understanding this, dear students? Yes, please make a note of this. Dear students, using maxima and minima, we can solve the problems of shortest distance between the curve and the line. And of course, sometimes even we can avoid that by just using the basic formula ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square will give the distance of the point from x1 comma y1 from the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So it's a very, very simple logic, dear students. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. And x1 comma y1, the distance between these two points is given by ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square. You can use this problem, you can use this formula to solve the next problem. Look at the question, dear students. The shortest distance between the line y minus x is equal to 1 and the parabola x is equal to y square is, we have four options, 2 root 3 by 8, 3 root 2 by 5, root 3 by 4, and 3 root 2 by 8. Look at this, dear students. Parabola is y is equal to x square. Y square is equal to x, or y is equal to x square, or one and the same. So, y is equal to x square is a parabola like this. Do you agree with me? So this is the parabola y is equal to x square. And the line x by minus 1 plus y by 1 is equal to x by minus 1 plus y by 1 is equal to 1. So x by minus 1, intercept form, plus y by 1 is equal to 1. So this is that line. Now the shortest distance is maybe this distance or this distance, we do not know. That has to be evaluated, right? To find out that, we have to use the concept of application of derivatives. But let us avoid it. See, we have x is equal to y square. Do you agree with me? So we can consider the point P as x, y. Instead of y, can I write it as root x? Because x is equal to y square or y is equal to root x. Therefore, the point is x, root x. Now, what is length of perpendicular from LOP, length of perpendicular from, you can bring it to the standard form, minus x or x minus y, you shift it to the right hand side, you will get x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0, x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0 to the point root x comma root x. So to the point x comma root x to x comma root x. What is the distance? X comma root x. So we can directly substitute here. In place of x, let me write it as x. In place of y, let me write it as root y root x minus root x plus 1 divided by. What should I write? X minus root x plus 1 divided by root of 1 square plus 1 square, that is equal to root 2. Is that correct? Now, in place of root x, can I write it as y? So that x will be equal to y square. So, you can write it as y square minus, in place of root x, I am writing it as y. Y square minus y plus 1 divided by root 2 we got, right? So the modulus, this is actually the shortest distance. Now what is the least value of it? The least value can be formed by completing this square. How to complete this square here? You can rewrite this as y minus 1 by 2 whole square, is that correct? Y minus 1 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 4 plus 1, is that correct? So minus 1 by 4 plus 1 is plus 3 by 4. Do you agree with me? I repeat this once again. Y minus 1 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 4. So minus 1 by 4 plus 1 will give us 3 by 4. So divided by root 2. Divided by root 2. 3 by 4 root 2. So y minus 1 by 2 whole square by root 2 plus 3 by 4 root 2. Do you agree with me? Do you agree with me, dear students? The least value of this is 3 by 4 root 2. The reason is very, very simple. Y minus 1 by 2, the minimum value is 0. This is 0 square by root 2. Therefore, this is 0. 0 plus 3 by 4 root 2, the least value is 3 by 4 root 2. So, 3 by 4 root 2, can we multiply with root 2 to the numerator and denominator? What happens? That is equal to 3 root 2 divided by 4 root 2 into root 2. That is 3 root 2 divided by 8, that is clearly, see, this is 3 root 2. I multiplied and divided by root 2. 3 root 2 divided by 4 into root 2 into root 2. 3 root 2 divided by 8. Therefore, option D is correct. The concept is very, very simple. What I did is, I consider the point as x comma root x, or you can consider as y square comma y also is okay. So, to this point, length of perpendicular from x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0 is given by x minus root x plus 1 by root 2 or y square minus y plus 1 by root 2. So, I am just completing this square there. So, we got y minus 1 by 2 whole square divided by root 2 plus 3 by 4 root 2. The least value is this, because this least value, the maximum value of this, minimum value of this is 0. So, you make this as 0, you will get the least value. 3 by 4 root 2 is same as 3 root 2 by 8. Therefore, option D is correct. Got it? Now, please make a note of this. Option D is correct for this. Dear students, look at the question, dear students. The problem is like this. F of x is equal to a minus 3x minus 2 less than or equal to x less than 0. 4x plus 3, 0 less than or equal to x less than 1. Then f of x has smallest value at x is equal to 0. Then range of a is, option a is minus infinity to 3, open bracket option a, option b minus infinity to 3, close bracket 3, and option c is open bracket 3 to infinity, and option d is open close bracket 3 to open bracket infinity. Definitely the graph, the curve is continuous, no doubt about it, because they have given smallest value at x is equal to 0. At x is equal to 0, the function has got smallest value is, you have to concentrate on this particular part, dear students. Observe carefully there, right? So, minus 2 less than or equal to x less than 0, 0 less than or equal to x less than 0. Now, what is f of 0 minus? What is f of 0 minus? Do you agree this is f of 0 minus? That is clearly equal to a. F of 0 is equal to f of 0 plus. Why it is? Because we have greater than or equal to 0. F of 0 or f of 0 plus is equal to 3. Do you agree with me? Because 4 into 0 plus 3. So, f of 0 plus is equal to 3. So, here, f of x is smallest value at x is equal to 3. So, f of x is smallest value at x is equal to 3 means f of 0 must be definitely greater than or equal to f of 0. I repeat, f of 0 minus must be definitely greater than or equal to f of 0, because f of 0 is smallest. As f of 0 is smallest, f of 0 minus must be greater than f of 0. That clearly says, you can see here, dear students, f of 0 minus must be greater than or equal to f of 0. Is that correct? So, therefore, what is f of 0 minus? A. A must be greater than or equal to 3. You can see here, 0 greater than or equal to x. Therefore, you are getting A greater than or equal to 3. A greater than or equal to 3 means this implies A belongs to 3 to infinity. So, whether we should put close bracket or open bracket, no doubt it must be a close bracket 3 and open bracket infinity, because we have greater than or equal to 3. Therefore, option D is correct. Actually, this is an IIT level question, dear students, and we solved using just common sense and the basics of continuity and differentiability. Of course, more of continuity, dear students. Dear students, the next problem is like this. A is minimum value of x squared plus 1 by 1 plus x squared. B is maximum value of integral part of sin x plus integral part of cos x. C is greatest value of cos of x into e power integral part of x plus 7x squared minus 3x. Then option A is equal to B is equal to C. Option B is A plus B is equal to C. And option C is A plus C is equal to B. And option D is B plus C is equal to A. Definitely, this is a question which confuses a lot. If you use application of derivative concepts, it takes at least 6 to 7 minutes to solve this problem. But let us use basic mathematics to solve this problem. The concept is like this. A is a minimum value of x squared plus 1 by 1 plus x squared. If you observe carefully, dear students, in the textbook, you will have an explanation like this. Find out f dash of x, then find out f double dash of x. When f double dash of x is negative, then f dash of x is equal to 0 will give us a maxima. After finding out maxima, you have to find out maximum value. Let us not use all those things, dear students. Just look at this. X square least value is 0. Do you agree with me? Just substitute x square as 0 because here also we have x square. So, the least value, if we substitute, then this implies A is equal to 0 plus 1 by 1 plus 0. 0 plus 1 by 1, that is equal to 1. We clearly got A is equal to 1. 33% of your problem is solved, coming to the value of B. Maximum value of integral part of sin x plus integral part of cos x. Do you agree with me? Integral part of sin x, maximum value is 1. Is that correct? Maximum. I'm talking about maximum. Plus, integral part of cos x, maximum value is also 1. I should write plus 1. Suppose, provided the condition, sin x and cos x, both of them should become 1. But at no point of time, sin x and cos x both becomes 1. That means to say, integral part of sin x plus integral part of cos x cannot be equal to 2 at all. Do you agree with me? It is impossible to get the value as 2. That means to say, maximum value of integral part of sin x plus integral part of cos x should be equal to 1. So that says, why should be equal to 1? Because it cannot be equal to 2. So now of course, when x is equal to 0, x is equal to pi by 2, you will get, if x is equal to 0, cos x is 1. If x is equal to pi by 2, sin x is 1, the counterpart is 0. Therefore, the value of b, this implies the value of b is equal to what? Value of b is also equal to 1. So, we got a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 1. So, we should get c is equal to 1. Is that right? No. We have to verify what is the value of c. Look at this, dear students. We have c is greatest value of cos of what we have. Can we take x common out of all? We have, if we take x common, we'll get e power integral part of x minus 7x squared plus minus 3x. Cos of x into something. Do you agree with me? Cos function has got a maximum value as 1 only when x is equal to 0 or 2n pi. So, we can make x is equal to 0 here. If x is equal to 0, we will get this as cos 0. Because 0 into anything is 0. This implies the value of c is also 1. The reason is cos function maximum value is equal to cos function maximum value is equal to 1. And fortunately, we are getting x is equal to 0 here. We can substitute x is equal to 0. We can make this as 0. Therefore, c is equal to 1. We got a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, c is equal to 1. Therefore, option a is correct. See how simple it is. An IIT level problem is solved by just using basics of mathematics. This is how you have to think, dear students. This is how you have to work out the problems of JEE mathematics and CET mathematics. Your way of thinking should be out of textbook way. That's why I repeatedly say this. You should complete your maths paper within 30 minutes. That's where you stand.